Sophie, and welcome to my crib. Oh, there's a door there, okay. My crib.
Travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the...
Yeah, so this is our living room. As you can see, it's very spacious, large windows. Oh, just give me 1 second. Sophie! Oh,
so, how much do you know about Julie Mehretu?
Well, I don't actually know that much, but I'd love to learn more.
Julie Mehretu, an American contemporary visual artist, was originally born in Ethiopia and moved to the U.S. when she was 7 years old in order to escape the terror and violence of her home country. Come on, let's learn some more.
She is now known for her multi-layer paintings of abstracted landscapes on a larger scale.
Her paintings, drawings, and prints depict urban and socio-political changes.
Her works feature an architectural taste layer with abstract overlay.
Her paintings range from small
to you live from the Julie Mehretu exhibit. We're going to be going around and interviewing people.
Yeah.
should I film? Okay, we're currently on the hunt for people to interview, but it's relatively empty, so we'll see how it goes. We're filming our zoom in. Okay, well, we're going to go ask that person. We'll see how it goes. Oh, that is a security guard. Never mind.
Okay.
All right. So, what are your first impressions of the exhibit?
Well, I'm just arrived, so I'm impressed by the paintings. They are very big.
They're huge.
Yeah. Huge, and I think the hugeness of it makes it very special.
Yeah.
And impressive.
No, I agree. Yeah. Is there a specific piece like in this room that caught your eye or stands out to you?
In the beginning, I thought you made a picture of it. I saw you making a picture of it. So just in the beginning in front of you with the black lines, I don't know.
No,
you know what it
good.
Is? Yeah.
You're good. Like, would you put these paintings in your own museum?
I like it very much.
Yeah.
I like the abstract art, so I like it very much. It's just the beginning. I only saw this
I know there's
here.
So many more rooms to go.
Yeah,
you got
but yeah,
all
I
right,
like
well,
it.
Thank you. Enjoy the rest of the exhibit.
Okay, and a lot of success.
Yeah, thank you. That's right, folks. Our vlog just went global. We got someone from Belgium.
Let's go.
Okay, what was your first impression of the exhibit?
I really love it, actually. I've never seen anything like it. It's stunning.
Oh, cool. Is there like a specific piece that like stands out to you or means something to you?
I actually like some of her earlier work the best. I like the one that it like both my mother and I both saw like the old classroom maps immediately from her images. I like the other one that looks like a room and there's like little pieces of maps in there. I think that's really beautiful. To me that sort of looked like a contained space, but you're sort of erasing different parts and there's sort of little sections left, but it's still within this room. I don't know what
that's
that
so
really
cool.
means, but that's what it looked like to me.
Would you put any of your pieces like in your own personal museum?
Absolutely.
Oh.
I would like a lot of them. I saw several of them said they're privately owned and I'm like, can I privately own something?
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Yeah. Good luck.
What were your first, impressions of the exhibit?
Intense.
Yeah, that's a good one. They're definitely big and colorful. I agree with you. And then is there a specific piece that stands out to you or maybe means something to you?
I liked the ones that depicted the wildfires. Yeah. But this room is really, it's really the most expressive of her, the art I've seen so far.
No, I it's like, this is definitely the most like out there room, I think, for sure.
I love this.
Yeah, this one, I know.
I absolutely love this one.
We've come
one.
Here like twice already, and this is the one that always I'm like, wow.
Right. So take a photo of that one and say, we love it.
She loves it. And then do you, like, would you put these pieces in your own museum?
If I had a museum, I would put some of them there. Yeah. Yes.
Nice. All right. Well, thank you so much. I love your glasses, by the way. Those are so cute.
Thank you.
Hi, could I interview you for a project?
Do I know you?
Yeah, like, it could be really fun. I don't know. Like, are you sure you don't want to be interviewed? Sarah.
Yes.
Hi, we're interviewing you now.
Oh, hello.
You've been enlisted.
Hello.
So what?
I can barely hear you.
What are your first impressions of the exhibit?
When I first walked in, I really liked it. Especially the ones when you first walk into the exhibit, they were very calming, and like they're chaotic yet visually appealing somehow.
Nice.
I like the ones with the bold colors. I like significantly less.
So going off of that, do you have a favorite piece?
Probably. Not sure which one though. It would have to be from the first, when you first walk in.
This is a vlog secret, but
that's not a secret I'll never tell. You know you love me. XOXO. Gossip Girl.
Would you put any of her pieces in a museum? If your museum.
Yeah, probably. Maybe some of the big ones, because they're just fun.
I agree. Thank you, Sarah.
Yeah.
You're such a good
recording.
Okay, so what is your guys' first impression of this exhibit?
First? Okay. I don't know, going into the first room of Mehretu's exhibit was very much like seeing her previous paintings which were in the gallery that I looked at for a previous project. Like, her style was very recognizable, but then like progressing through each of the rooms, very different, you know? The paintings looked a little darker. This room over here, room three, was more graffiti inspired, or at least that's what I thought. And I thought it was interesting to see her, you know, variety in her pieces.
And I also thought it was interesting to see so many of like very similar styles that were unique but like very, very similar, and then go to the next room and yeah, there were like specific ones that way stood out to me, like the big calligraphy looking one.
Oh.
I think that one's really cool. It's very similar in that it's big but not much else.
That ties into my next question, like, are there any pieces that stood out to you or had any significance?
Yeah, I really like that one, just because none of the other ones really, well, it looked like it had, like, allusions to nature and, like, stuff like that, and I feel like I didn't see that in many of the other ones. I saw mostly, like, architecture and stuff like that.
The pieces that stood out to me were definitely Untitled 2, I think it's called, and Dispersion in the first room. Just seeing the curator place them next to each other and how they were like complete opposites. One, you know, the like focal point of the piece was surrounding the center, creating like an illusion of chaos, whereas the other one, like the chaos was divided on each side and there was like a moment of calm and serenity in the middle of the piece. That was a really cool placement to curate.
Wow, that sounds cool.
Thanks.
So, would you put any of these pieces in your own personal museum?
I would put the one that I talked about. I don't know what it's called though.
Yeah, I think definitely like one of these pieces in this room or in room one. The color palette and like the way that her and her team created the pieces, definitely, yeah, I would include one.
Cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Pretty. Look at her. She's like a depressed artsy art student sitting in a museum. Very dramatic. Very artsy. We love you, Julia. Welcome to the vlog. Thank you. Sarah.
Sarah, turn over here. You're being filmed.
I'll help you.
Welcome to the vlog. To our loyal viewers, raise your hand. Yes, you who are watching the video currently, raise your hand if you think we should go ask the security guards what they think of the exhibit.
Look at all those hands raised.
Oh my gosh, you guys are so supportive of our dreams. Okay, let's go ask. These are our super sneaky spy camera helper people. Would you like to introduce yourselves?
I'm Maddie Johnson.
I'm Zoe.
And I'm Haya Fine. What are your first impressions of this exhibit?
Very abstract. You have a lot of pieces where you can just kind of look at it and just zone out a little bit.
I
don't know. It's kind of up to your own interpretation how you feel about the artwork.
Is there a particular piece that like speaks to you or maybe that you like the best?
I would assume this one right here. It's kind of like...
We had someone else say that one. Awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. Tyron was like the... abstract volcano or something like that.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Yeah,
something like that.
And then if you had like your own art museum, would you put this exhibit in your museum?
I think I would. Maybe not all the pieces. Maybe it was like the one of the big ones where you just kind of zone out, just look at it. It would probably help a lot with like Instagram posts like that.
Nice.
Models go crazy for it.
Yeah, awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.